show you a video which shows two perspectives of humans. The one, who the person who is disabled and uses a wheelchair, and the other is a normal human.
Here you can see four legs of the wheelchair, the four wheels, a seat, a backrest, and a well-cushioned armrest. Now, during the transformation, the rear leg comes front because it's hinged to the front leg. And this pedal-like handle and the rear wheel are attached with a chain, which enables the person for his mobility. He can move forward and backward and apply brakes wherever he wants to, along with the wheelchair. Now, in this seat, which is attached to these two front legs, will go down. And you see this cylindrical thing, this enables the seat to go down and form a 90 degree angle between the backrest and the seat. So the next picture, what's going to look like, something like this. The leg has come in the front, backrest, and the seat has gone below in the axis of the backrest. So this enables the person, this creates a space for the person to stand in between and use it as a crutch. Now generally you'd ask me the question of height. This is not correct height for the crutch. So what we've done is we've used the telescope technology. The concept behind the telescope is initially it's small, but you can increase the length of it by moving around, which gives you a better view of the picture or whatever. Now the next picture, it's going to show you how the length is increased and it goes down. So it provides the wheelchair user to set the height according to him and use it as a proper crutch and move wherever he wants to. I can see the questions arising about the wheel that is as the base of the crutch. To solve that, we provided an advanced push or pull lock system, which locks the wheel completely in the crutch mode. So now, even though it's a circular looking thing, it won't rotate at all, even though in contact with the ground. And the armrest becomes this underarm support for the person which supports it. And this pedal-like handle, it becomes a support for the person to lift it and actually move forward. That's how it is, it solved the previous problem. Coming to the benefits part, it eliminates the need for an assistant completely. So you can now be more independent, a wheelchair user, he can be more proud of himself, he can explore the world more properly, and obviously, you're more independent, you don't need anyone. And it is easier to cross any type of terrain, strains, or uneven surfaces. Now the person can alternate between wheeling and walking. If he's tired of walking, he can also walk, and if he's tired of walking, he can also go on the wheel. Now the features are lightweight frame, aluminium and carbon fiber. Easy manual conversion, well cushioned seat, and easy to maneuver. And then let's not forget about the lock, which I told you about the wheel. It's advanced pull or push lock system. We've also introduced our prototype to some of the doctors, and this is what they had to say.
We see many patients who are wheelchair bound. The main obstacle these patients face is stairs and strolls. Any innovation which can address such a disability can help these patients move independently. Rollstrol is a product which can convert from wheelchair to crutches manually. It is very lightweight. Being cost effective, it is very helpful for countries like India where there is not proper facilities for wheelchair bound people, and it can also help penetrate the developing countries. Thank you.
Dr. Praveen Chaudhary had this to say. They thought the product was very revolutionary. The person can be independent and enable him to do things which he was never able to do before.
Now, our targeted market segment are the disabled people or the elderly who have some ability to stand and walk on their own, but they need support, or they tire very quickly and thus they're not able to cover large distances without an assistant. We plan to start our product in India, where there are very few places with wheelchair-friendly services, and we have many people who would be willing to use our product. Then we plan to move on to Southeast Asia, where very few of the countries have wheelchair-friendly services, and they're small, and we can sell our product easily there. So we plan on moving to Singapore and Malaysia next. But our main goal is to finally move to the USA, where technology is available to climb the stairs and, you know, uneven terrain, but it's hard to use and it's extremely expensive, which is why we think our product will sell well there. Now, these are just a few facts about our market size. And the global market for wheelchairs is likely to reach 10.6 million units by 2020, that's in 4 years. The Indian market size, when we conducted some research, the Indian market size for wheelchairs was about 2 lakhs, but about 1,60,000 are suitable for using our product. That is, they have some ability to walk, but they need support and they need assistance, and they can't walk for very long. And the Indian market shows about 10% growth per annum.
Talk about the marketing segments and the marketing strategies. The marketing segments we chose are B2B, as we have very limited resources, and they are hospitals and clinics, railway stations and airports, malls and other public places, NGOs and old age homes. The strategies we chose to increase our market, expand our market, is social media, newspaper articles, organized marathons for the disabled people, and marketing groups.
This is our business plan for the next 3 years. We plan to concentrate on the Indian market primarily, and in around 1,60,000 wheelchairs are sold annually in India, and we plan to have a market share of at least 5% in the first year, which will increase to around 20% by the third year, and an average wheelchair will cost you anywhere between 7,000 to 10,000 rupees. Our product is placed at 17,500 because of the facilities that we provide with it. We worked out all the expenses, and the revenue which we expect in the first year is around 1.6 crore, and the profit after taxes is coming to around 31 lakhs in the first year, and 1 crore 50 lakhs for the third year.
1 minute.
We are going to source our carbon fiber from Hexcel, and we have also tied up with Sunrise Medical as our manufacturing partner. And we plan to distribute with wheelchair dealers such as Autobock and Pride Mobility. Those were some pictures of our competition, and after conducting some research, we have found that our product is the most lightweight, has relatively good capacity, is the cheapest, and has the conversion to crutches. Our main risks would be future competitors who also choose to, you know, start a business in this market, and any regulatory risk that might come up with our product. In the next 5 years, we want to enhance our product line by automation or improving the material sciences, launching a model in the next 2 years, and launching in the international market in the next 3 years. We actually contacted 3D printing and you know the people who make the prototype, but we figured it would cost too much, so we decided to go with an on-screen image instead.
The dimensions and all are very accurate. We've talked to our physicians. They also do like spine, the center of gravity, the center of mass, all are looking good. Those who are working can probably use it as a crutch and a wheelchair.
We can see that design.
Yes. The technical part has also been taken care of. It's only a conceptual design. We couldn't get the 3D image of all the technologies and the screw holes and the minute information about the thing on this, because the person wasn't that scared. So we could only do this.
Oh, you did a 3D simulation?
Yeah, we approached them,
but we had to use the drawings instead because those were too complex and they were taking too long to produce.
So there are maybe not as good as yours, hopefully you'll have a good product, but there are other products that do something similar in the market. They do, so when you put your competition, you not included those that actually do some form of conversion.
Yeah, we actually had no videos, but we're running out of time, so we couldn't
say. I'm talking about the competition slide. Your visitor, they are not really your relevant competitor. There are others who actually convert. Right? I mean, there are, again, like I said, maybe yours is a much superior product, possibly, hopefully.
So,
but
the other products, they are basically automated, and our product is manual, and it costs, it's not that expensive as the other products.
For example, this
calendar. What I'm saying is that besides all of these, none of these are convertible, right? I mean, therefore, that seems to indicate you have this edge. But I'm saying there are convertible, you know, mechanisms out there. Wheelchairs, maybe, like I said, maybe you have a much bigger product. I'm not denying that. But that's your relevant comparison.
This particular component, the stereo, converts into something else, which helps. This takes into the formation, and this actually makes the person climb the chair. This is actually a convertible wheelchair.
So why does it say no?
It doesn't convert into crutches.
We actually have a video clip. Can we show you that?
That's okay. I just go for your own. So it's not the crutches. It's the mobility, right? So that if I have to, so you're saying the equivalent of the crutch can be done here by that particular product?
No.
So what does it do?
Basically, it extends kind of like a tractor, like a tractor tread. And then it takes a really long time to climb up the stairs, and it's slow and automated.
And while the person has to do so much electrical work on his arm, so that it can actually work. So it takes quite a long for a person to just climb one stair. While our product, when it's transferred into a garage, the person can easily go upstairs. With his own
That's all we hope it will happen. Right? I mean, because we haven't seen it actually working yet. But again, I'm not denying all the work you've done. But the hope is that it translated into actual performance.
In your market analysis, right, you took the market share of 160,000 units, right, from the Slovenia market, right? Now, what percentage of that are people who actually can stand up?
The total requirement for wheelchairs in India is about 2 lakhs, and 160,000 are people who can use our product, that is, they have some ability to stand and walk on their own.
Like, particularly our
women try to take that subset.
Yes.
Have you thought about what kind of product testing that you needed on this, and certifications, and any legalities?
Probably by the IMA, the Indian Medical Association, we will approach them for our test. As I told you, the physicist and all of them is approved, so probably it will work out.
If you're making significant profit year one, what do you think is the reason why you should not start this today?
In the sense of our age,
you can
like we will start it, obviously we will start it, but once we are all graduated and well educated, we'll get more information about this stuff. We'll have a better business than starting now.
Why should some not be over? Let's say, can you think of any reason why somebody here today out of a student should not start this today? You're making like 20% back out of the year once, right?
We filed a patent already, so you can't really start it.
So I wasn't quite convinced of your need to, the reason why you went to the US market suddenly, right? You made the case that it's in the developing markets where the need is more compelling, right? Therefore, I would have thought that, well, let's saturate the developing market first. So the need is less compelling, I would take a Western client unit. Maybe there's a right gap for it, but it's not brought on clearly.
Where you want to target the USA after the Southeast Asian region would be because all those competitors, they're like predominant in the USA and the UK and, you know, other countries, but they're extremely expensive and they're automated, and the lower middle class or like the middle class, they can't afford those because they amount up to about $50,000 for just one unit. And what we feel is our product can make a huge difference there because it's affordable, and you know, people in the middle class with disabilities will be able to use it too.
And also, if you see, we're not directly approaching USA because we know the technologies are much advanced over there than compared to our technology. But the fact that ours is cheaper, ours is more feasible, makes it to our advantage that if we go there, people might be interested in our product. Like, who wouldn't want to pay less for the same product, but a better product? Everyone would want to.
In terms of customer evaluation, like you guys know any relations of the deal, did you do a survey or something to approach?
Yes, we have approached a few people. I can tell you the quotes they told me. Like, I asked a person from Nizamabad. She's a regular wheelchair user, and when I showed my prototype to her, she said that if I knew this product was launched before, like if it were to be launched before, I could have started my studies at much earlier age. That's what she told me. And the other person told me, like, it's a very good product. I wish I could use it someday so that I really hope I can explore the world more properly.
Very amazing proposal. Really nice. This is Architect Srishti here. I'm doing PhD here at RIIIT. Would request you to just put the slide in which you are having the wheelchair and the converted. Okay. Yeah, can you just shift it a bit so that it's covered? Okay. So, although the idea is really amazing, very easy, very cheap, all the benefits, everything is there. But according to me, you have done an amazing study when you are comparing it with the wheelchair. But I think there is a little bit of correction. If you do it, it is really amazing and it will be totally converted. That is, when you look at the basic design of a crutch, okay? So can you just show how the person moves? Exactly. Now you look in this.
Okay, I know.
It is like this, right? You are having a back support. When the person is moving forward, he needs support over there.
You mean the back is being
So it is convertible. I mean, you can always rotate it, okay? But there would be an issue with the vision because your back seat is high, so the vision problem will be there. Okay, because somebody, when they want to climb the step, they want to also see the step. Okay, so if you just like the way you pushed your this part.
The sides.
Down. If you can just put this also down.
And then move the sides.
The person is not standing behind the seat, he's standing in front of the seat. the back end and see the coming behind.
Use
mind. So in that case, movement will be obstructed.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
What I'm saying is that, see, one thing. What I'm saying is that the reason why the design of it is like this is that you can lift it, you can see forward, and when you want to take the step forward, you're having support to hold it and move forward.
Okay.
Okay. So in the sense we are having that, that's what I'm saying. This design will be easy for over. If you are standing like this, you can easily do it like this. Right? But the vision problem is there.
Let's give a big round of applause. So, we are out of time, but please catch up with them all.
Actually, I want to catch up with you guys later because I wanted to import wheelchairs when I was in the States. I did this survey, I was very much into this, what you are talking about. But please meet me. I'll give you a whole lot of information on that.
That's awesome. I think you are well. You are going to shape up the product. So the mentor for this team is Srinivas Sathi. I would like to request him to come here and say a few words for the team. No. I did not need a wheelchair.
It was really fun working with this team. I know this is a very phony, you know, it's a business plan competition where you don't really have to have something working out of a 9th to 12th graders. But these people have done an amazing job. What I like is they chose a topic which is not techie, you know, an app or a portal or something like that. And they have really done a lot of work which a regular business entrepreneur should do, which they have done. So quite amazing to see, a lot of talent, a lot of focus. You know, wish you all the very best. I wish to see you actually entrepreneurs out of, you know, immediately after, when you can drop out of a college.
Thank you. Thank you, team. Great job. So next team presenting is Kalopia.